Shalom, once again, Brother Eleazar is here.
Shalom.
Isaiah, say shalom.
Shalom.
Amariah.
Shalom.
All right, and Brother
Keith. Shalom.
Brother Chief, we're here with the magnificent, the great Mr. W. One letter, and that's all you need to know. Mr. W. So Mr. W, I mean, he is actually suggesting that he's a Christian, and we're going to find out from which perspective is he actually alluding to himself as being a Christian. Now, Mr. W, you are aware that Israelites, or Hebrews, you know, is where this whole philosophy of Christianity derived from. You are aware of that, right,
yes,
sir?
Yes.
You know, before people being called Christians, you are aware that it was actually referred to as Hebrews.
Right.
And, you know, because of the patriarch Abraham, and Isaac,
right,
and Jacob,
right,
which makes them Israelites, whose name was actually changed to Israel. So we're the children of Yahshua Allah. So I'm going to ask you, Mr. W, in this day and time, with all of the Israelites around, why are you referring to yourself as a Christian? And please explain to me, what do you exactly mean when you refer to yourself as a Christian? Now, the first thing I'm going to ask you, Mr. W, is, can you tell me what the word Christian means?
Well, what it means, in the definition of what I've learned, or what I think I've learned in the correct way, followers of Christ, and the Master's add-on to his chosen people in an expansion to the whole world.
Right, right, right.
Because, as we well know, that the chosen people did not expand upon the whole world.
As Stop right there. You say that the chosen people did not expand,
yes,
upon the entire world?
Right.
Now, I got two problems with that. The first thing I'm going to ask you is, who are the chosen people according to the Bible?
Yeah.
The Jews, and also called Hebrews.
Okay, Eleazar, can someone take the camera for a minute so I can go over here by this brother? No, I want him to hold it over here. I'm going to move over here. I don't have a Bible, but I have my phone. And yo, brother, can you get Luke 21, 24 to prove all things? Now, the brother, Mr. W, I'm going to say shalom to you. I understand you're a Christian, but I'm going to show you when Israelites start referring to themselves as Christians. But the first thing we're going to do is we're going to address the issue of you claiming and making an accusation that the Christians did not expand throughout the world.
Right.
So let's get Luke 21:24 to prove all things. Now, before we go into that, if you are a Christian, you just admitted you as a follower of Christ, right?
Yes.
So it doesn't matter what anyone else said. The most important one to follow is the one that you refer to as Christ.
Right.
Yahweh Shah or Yeshua, right? So anything that anyone else says is irrelevant to what he says, because he's supposed to be the Savior, right?
Right.
According to your beliefs.
Right.
All right, let's read, brother.
Luke 21:24. And they shall fall by the edge of the sword.
Now, who are they talking about? They're talking about the Israelites.
Yeah.
This is the prophecy of the temple being destroyed for the second time in 70 AD by the Romans. Mm-hmm. Read on.
And shall be led away captive into all nations.
Into where?
Into all nations.
Into where?
Into all nations.
Into all nations, Mr. W.
Right.
So hold on, now we got a problem. Because you just said that the Israelites was not dispersed throughout the world. So who is he dealing with? He's dealing with the Israelites.
Yeah.
Get Matthew 15:24. I'm going to show you something. Hold that, brother.
Okay.
Get Matthew 15:24. I'm going to show you, despite what you have been taught and what you think, he only dealt with the Israelites.
True.
He was only sent to the Israelites.
Right.
Now I see what he said himself out of his own mouth. Matthew 15:24. See what you got, brother.
So you can call yourself a Christian,
yes,
as long as you mean it from the perspective of following Yahawashah HaMashiach. Mm-hmm. Or HaMashiach Yahawashah. No, read it a little louder because
we want the
audience to hear you, Mr. Debbie. Okay. We want to make sure that they can hear you.
I was sent only to the lost sheep of Israel.
No, he was sent to the Greeks
also.
No. He said I was only sent to the lost sheep of Israel. Who said that?
The Christ.
Who said that?
The Christ.
Who said that?
The Messiah, Savior Christ.
The Christ said he was only sent to the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
Right.
So now we got a problem. Mm-hmm. Finish reading what you got. So we've actually already found out two things here.
Yeah.
That the Israelites were scattered throughout the world, according to Matthew 21, mm-hmm, or Luke 21:24.
Yeah.
And Christ, out of his own mouth, said he was only sent to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. Not the whole world, not unto the Greeks, mm-hmm, not unto the Romans, not unto the Polish, not unto the Dutch, but unto Israel.
Right.
Unto Israel, mm-hmm, not the whole world. Read what you got, buddy.
And Jerusalem shall be trodden down of the Gentiles until the times of the Gentiles be fulfilled.
Until the time of the Gentiles be fulfilled.
Right.
Now, Jerusalem was destroyed, right?
Yes.
Who's occupying Rome, our area right now?
That area?
Yeah, who's occupying where we're supposed to be?
Well, I haven't taken all the land, but they've taken most of the land that they were supposed to have.
But in 1948, with the assistance of America, the people that's calling themselves Jews set up a forged state,
right,
named Israel.
Israel.
And they went over there, and now they're occupying our land.
Right.
But the prophecy doesn't say that we will be there in the last days, does it?
It does.
No, it doesn't.
Said the Jews will return to Israel.
I beg to differ. I beg to differ. The prophecy says in the last days that the Israelites will be scattered throughout the earth amongst the Gentiles.
Right.
Let them finish Luke. Finish reading that. Watch this. Yeah. That's down.
Okay, calm down.
Go ahead,
I'm going to finish reading that.
He all finished right. It. Let get that Luke. Watch this.
Luke 28.
No, 21. Got you got 20, right?
21 and 25.
Go ahead.
Luke. I'm sorry.
No, you stay in Matthew.
Hold on. You stay in
Matthew. And there shall be a sign in the sun.
Go to 24. If you finish 24, read the whole 24.
Oh yeah, I read the whole 24.
Read it again.
And they shall fall by the edge of the sword, and shall be led away captive into all nations. And Jerusalem shall be trodden down of the Gentiles, and until the time of the Gentiles be fulfilled.
You hear that? So how long is other nations going to be in Jerusalem? It said until the time of the Gentiles is fulfilled. That means when they have no more rain.
Right.
All
right.
Now we see all these Caucasian nations reigning, right? Mm-hmm. So what does that tell us? That tells us this is still the time of the Gentiles. So since this is still the time of the Gentile, how is it that they're claiming that the Jews are in Jerusalem? But this is currently the time of the Gentiles' reign.
When it's still inside.
Now, well, that's who's holding the ball.
Well, yeah, Mr.
Five verse eight. And the remnant of Jacob.
Now the remnant of Jacob, the remainder of Jacob, mm-hmm, who's Jacob? The Israelites. Because Jacob's name was changed to Israel. Go ahead.
Shall be among the Gentiles.
Shall be among the Gentiles. Not in Israel. In the last days, the prophecy saying we will be amongst the Gentiles. Read on.
In the midst of many people.
In the midst of many people. Not in Israel. In Jerusalem. All over the earth. Overlaying the scriptures with Luke 21:24. Read on.
As a lion amongst the beasts of the forest.
As a lion amongst the beasts of the forest. So in the last days, we're going to be like young lions. Go ahead.
As a lion of the beast of the forest. As a young lion among the flock of sheep.
As a young lion amongst the flock of sheep.
Who, if he go through, both tread it down and tear it into pieces.
So the prophecy says in the last days, we're going to destroy these nations that's ruling over us. But my reason for pulling that scripture, it says in the last days we will not, the masses of our people, the bulk of our people would not be in Israel. They would be scattered throughout the four corners of the earth. Contrary to what you said, Mr. W.
Right.
Contrary. Now, what I want you to do is get the book of Acts. Get Acts the 11th chapter. I'm going to show you something. I'm going to show you that the Christians are Israelites. Acts 11, verse 26. Acts 11 and 26. Because the Christians were first called, the Israelites was first called Christians where?
In Acts, I think 11, 26.
We're going to find out. Get Acts 11, 26.
Yes.
And when he found him,
he
brought him to Antioch.
He brought him to Antioch. Where's Antioch on the map?
Syria.
That's Upper Syria.
Right.
Antioch is Upper Syria.
That. So for a whole year, Barnabas and Saul met with the church.
Remember?
And taught great numbers of people.
So remember, Paul was teaching people to be followers of your Hamashiach, your Hawashiach,
right.
And they wanted to slay him.
Right.
Go ahead.
The disciples were called Christians first at Antioch.
So the disciples were first called Christians in Antioch, letting you know that the disciples was who? Israelites. Israelites. So the real Christians are what? Israelites.
Well, not necessarily real.
No, the depends. Only Christians are Israelites.
Well, that was the first. The church was,
well,
luckily.
Check this out. Check this out, Chief. Mm-hmm. Not the country. But if you are a Christian, you told me what that meant, right?
Right.
What does it mean again?
Followers of Christ.
Followers of Christ. You got that, right?
Right.
So if you're not following the ways of Hamashiach Yahawashah, then you're not a Christian.
Right.
If you're not keeping the Shabbat, you're not a Christian. You're just something else. You're playing some magic.
Well,
if you're not keeping the dietary laws, you're not a Christian.
Right. But by the same token, what this also encompasses is this. The last covenant reigns with the Christ. So we know the communication of how the Master was putting across what he wanted. You see, this tops all doctrines. The doctrine of Christ. The covenant of Christ. Those who know Christ also really know the Master. And so it's to top all doctrines, forecoming and thereafter. And even then, see, missionaryism first shows up with Christianity.
I don't understand the relevance of you mentioning that.
Well, you see, in order for God to take on to the world, this was a plan that he had to utilize because he knew that they're going to have a hard time. So I have to put something in there, a transformation, an insert, to get what I want. Because the Hebrews did not follow the Christ Messiah. In fact, they had him killed.
That's not true.
Well, not all.
Now in sight.
Yeah, I know.
That's not true, sir.
Well, it's not true in the sense that all the
it's
Jews...
It's not true scripture-wise.
Well, see, the last covenant reigns with the Christ. So if nobody if everybody doesn't understand that, then everybody's not going to understand who the Master is. You get it?
No, see, you're trying to play semantics.
No,
you're trying to tap dance, and you can't tap dance with me. You're trying to use words, but you're not. You haven't pulled one scripture yet. Get Matthew, brother. Get Matthew 23 verse 2. Get Matthew. What you got? Get Matthew 23 verse 2.
That was already.
Yeah, you're trying to tap dance, man. You're trying to dance around. So, Mr. W.
Dance around for what?
No, you're trying to dance around for the truth. You're trying to say something was actually misconstrued. You haven't pulled one scripture. What you're doing is you're using your logic and trying to say, well, the Messiah did this. But so far, we're seeing that Hamashiach Yahawashah himself kept the laws, right? He kept the laws.
Yeah, that's
all right, let's get Matthew 23, verse 2, brother.
Matthew 23, verse 2. And it says, same scribes and the Pharisees sit in Moses' seat.
Okay, the scribes and the Pharisees sat in Moses' seat. Listen well. Listen well, Mr. W.
Yeah.
What does that mean? They sat in Moses' seat. What did Moses do? He taught our people the law, right?
Right.
He taught our people the law, statutes, and commandments.
Right.
How many law, statutes, and commandments are there, Mr. W?
Well, there's quite a few.
How many is it? over 632. Now my question to you is, which one did you bring today?
I don't think I'm a Christian, anyone. Right? The only one I'm
you're a Christian.
The only one the Christians are really fully aware to
are what, the ten?
Are the covenants. The last covenant.
No, but you're not asking what laws are you what laws are you what you
got. Those are
finish reading what you got, brother. Finish reading what you got, brother.
Look, verse
listen,
three.
Listen, Mr.
All therefore, whatsoever they bid you observe.
So he said, since the scribes and the Pharisees sit in Moses' seat,
yeah,
whatever they tell you to do, you do. Why? Because they knew the law.
Right.
The scribes wrote down the laws, mm-hmm. and the Pharisees were the orators mm-hmm. that had the laws memorized, and they taught them by right. speaking.
By speaking.
So he's basically telling us to do what? Keep the laws.
Keep the laws. Right.
Are you keeping the laws, Mr. Jeff? Are you keeping the Shabbat?
Probably not.
Probably not. Probably. Yeah, here we go with the semantics again.
You're a follower of Christ, though, right?
Yes.
Okay, I'm going to keep going. And it says that observe and do.
Right.
But do not ye after their words. So they say, and do not. You hear that?
Do not. Yeah,
it says, do not after their words. For the Pharisees and the scribes, they say the law, but they do not the law.
Right.
That's what it's saying.
Start from the first.
Well, for one thing, they didn't know the new covenant.
Where's your wire? No, this is in Matthew. With the new covenant. So this is saying, Christ kept the law. So it's saying, the Pharisees and scribes, they ministered the law.
Right.
But they didn't keep it.
Right.
And this book right here, mm-hmm. Christ is telling you, you need to do the law.
Right.
So.
But you see, nobody knew that the Christ was going to be the gospel. Until at a certain time.
What do you mean going to be the gospel? We knew that with John.
Right. But they didn't know. See, they had to see.
I knew that in Isaiah. They,
I know, but you had to see the Christ when he came. So as to cater to the undead understanding.
So, I mean, you being a Christian, right?
Yes.
A follower of Christ.
Yes.
Right? Or are you supposed to be keeping the laws?
Yes.
So, what does that make you?
But you see, you have one thing that tops all the laws.
What's that?
Paul tells you that.
What's that?
The Christ Messiah. Those who call upon the name of the Christ Messiah.
You saying the Christ Messiah tops all the laws?
Yes.
Now get John. Get John the first chapter, man. John 1 not, verse 1. Whoa. I'm going to cut you right there, Mr. You saying he tops all of the laws. He is the law.
Right.
He is the word. And he is the Lord.
Right.
The Lord is Hamashiach Yahweh Shah. Because he was back in the beginning with Yahweh.
Right.
And I'll show you that.
Right.
Khan.
In the beginning was the Word.
Okay, when the beginning, what is that word? What is that word?
The Word was the Lord.
The Word is Hamashiach Yahweh Shah. Yeah, in the beginning was the Word.
Right.
And the Word was with God.
And when you read that in the Hebrew, man, it says the Word was with God. The powers. And with Him, the powers.
Right.
So it was more than one. You understand that, right?
What do you mean more than one?
It was more than one power.
Yahweh was just not there himself when he was creating this world. Hamashiach Yahweh Shah was right there with him. Read that part again so he can get the understanding.
In the beginning was the Word.
That Word is Christ. That Lord is Christ. Read it.
And the Word was with God.
The Word was with Yahweh. The Word was with Yahweh. The Word was with Yahuwah. You understand? Read.
And Christ was the first made.
Right.
And the Word was God.
And the Word was God.
Right.
He is the God of this world.
Right.
He's not Hamash. He's not Yahweh. But he is the God of this world.
World God of this world.
He said all power was given to me. Read.
The same was in the beginning with God.
The same was in the beginning with Yahweh.
Right.
Read.
All things was made by him.
All things was made by him, Mr. W.
Right. And for him.
And without him was not anything made that was made.
So the law is him.
Right.
So when you're saying the law and all of that, he is the law.
Right.
So it goes back to him. So whatever he did, are you not supposed to be doing that, Mr. W?
Right.
So my question is, why are you not keeping the laws? Why do you shave off your beard, Mr. W?
For one thing.
Why do you shave off your beard, Mr. W?
Well, I did.
That's the law. You should not mar the corners of your bed.
Right.
Meaning to cut them off. Don't mar the corners of your bed.
I did a little missionary work before you guys came.
Okay.
Today.
All right.
Some guy came in and he didn't understand a lot of factors of the Bible. I explained quite a few of them.
Unless you're teaching the Bible the way that we're teaching this, get Isaiah 28 verse 10. The way that you're teaching the Bible, Mr. W, mm-hmm. not to cut you is off.
Yeah.
Isaiah 28 verse 10 tells us how the Bible should be taught.
Right.
Precept upon precept.
Right.
Precept upon precept, line upon line. Mm-hmm. Here a little, there a little.
Isaiah 28 and 10. For precept must be upon precept. Precept. For precept must be upon precept. Precept upon precept. Line upon line. Here a little and there a little.
Meaning you can't read the Bible in a chronological order. That's why we jump around from place to place. Because it is not written in the order that it's in.
It's not written in a perfect layout.
Yeah, right.
And
that's
story,
what problems the Bible, what people have with the Bible. Of course, then again, that's what makes it a religion too.
No, 2 Timothy 2 and 15 tell you to study and show yourself a fool.
Oh yeah,
show me.
What I'm trying to